Hey everybody, so this is the fourth update on my DIY MFT, and you'll see that it's almost done. So I do have a lot of accessories on here that I'm gonna walk through in this video, but I'm very happy with how the sides came together and how the holes were drilled. So I think it was 516 holes that were drilled overall, because I had to do 3 millimeter pilot hole, then I had to drill the 20 millimeter holes for the dogs, and then using the reamer bit, which I'll show you, and putting the chamfer on top. So lots of that, but very happy with the sides. Again, much faster than I'd expected, just using some clamps to hold them together, being able to drill in the base. The alignment, even though these were cut a couple of weeks ago, was pretty much bang on. So I don't know, maybe sometimes they were off by half a millimeter, quarter of a millimeter. So pretty good overall. And the space in the inside, and I've cleaned it all out, really quite good. Drilled into the base just through here, or screwed into the base there. You can see the kind of the nice shadows of the holes on the bottom. And yeah, just to show you kind of the other side. Yeah, really quite happy with this. And even like the MDF top with the base, or the bottom of the torsion box, came together really quite nicely. So very happy with this. The holes themselves, so again, had to drill a lot of them. And just to show you what they look like without the reamer. So here's the bit actually in the drill. So the chunkiest bit that I've ever seen. So the reamer basically takes it, so if there's any sort of swelling in the hole and you just kind of need to make it just a tiny bit wider, it does that. And then it also has, let's take a look over here. You'll see this carbide kind of blade in there. And what that does is it just puts that very slight chamfer in here. What that does is if you're sliding material over, it doesn't really get caught. And not that it would too much on these, but if it did, it could damage the top of those holes. Whereas with that chamfer, it'll slide over. Plus a lot of the dogs that are used from UJK and a lot of other brands kind of have a tiny bit of a collar on it. Let me grab one and show you. So a lot of them have this tiny little collar. So it just helps to solidify it just a little bit more so that can sit in completely recessed, which is pretty cool. So yeah, I think as far as screw ups, I know I've been pretty open about that on this table. So one here where I was just kind of drilling into the corner, hit a screw that I already had in the side. So put that there. And I think on the other side of the table, yeah, I had just kind of missed the mark as far as drilling into the cross piece there. So I think that was about it, and I did change my mind. So let's take a look at this map. So I was originally going to do this pattern. Actually, let's go back to the position where we were going to do this. And what I did choose to do is still keep the gap all the way across this way, because I am going to be breaking down full sheet goods, and just to be able to have kind of a little bit of a river of solid MDF is quite handy. But then here I decided, actually, and let's flip this up to show you, rather than kind of opening that space up, I just put a couple of offset holes in here. So with those offset holes, the blade is going to fit perfectly in between the holes, so no big deal. Whereas if I put it on kind of the primary hole, that one, it would have kind of gone directly over this. So these two offset, so if I kind of used it really well at this point, then I could move it to over here. And also if I needed to drill more, I can use the PARF guide system just to drill a couple more offset holes. So this is the jig that I use. So this was purchased from Axminster. You can get it from Lee Valley and a few other places. Lots of accessories, really nice bits. They are Centrotech bits, but you can use them in any drill. You don't need to have a Festool Centrotech, but if you are using other drills, I highly recommend that you just have like one of these little hex adapters. Just makes it easier to take the bit in and out, because when you are doing the 20 millimeter holes, you need to take it out every single time. So kind of worked up my fingers a little bit. I think I had a Band-Aid in one of my earlier videos when I was kind of in the middle of that. So anyways, let's just talk through a few accessories, because I think I have gotten a few questions like, why would you want all these holes on here? And there are a few reasons why. One, let me show you over here, just kind of a couple of the features of the bench. So I can take these clamps, so this is the same as this one, and I can put them through those holes and clamp in any spot. So I can do that from the top or from the bottom. I also, just because this is about 10.5 inches, I can use 12 inch clamps to clamp 3/4 inch material from the actual base of the workbench, which is really handy. Just take a look under here so you can see what those clamps look like. Then another one that I want to show. Oh yeah, this one's kind of funky. So this cam and wedge set, again from Axminster Tools, made by UJK, or UJK is their brand. So you'll see this piece is loose. Got a couple dogs there. Just slide this wedge in there and then just pull this cam. Now it's, of course it'll lift up, but it's really, really quite solid. So any sort of sanding. The only thing I wish with this is that these pieces are pretty much exactly 3/4 inch thick. I wish they were closer to 1/2 inch, just so that then when I am working with 3/4 inch material, I don't have to deal with that. So it's all right, but so I'll be using these a lot. And even if I have to kind of put a little sliver of something a little narrower, just so when I am sanding, I can get over that edge. And for the dogs here, so this set did come with 3 dogs. You can also use this as kind of a fence behind it. But yeah, pretty happy with that. And I may actually look at getting another one or two of these when I make an order from Axminster in the future. And then here's kind of one of the main reasons why I wanted this sort of table. So using these super dogs, I think you could use any dogs. I don't think they need to be these super dogs from UJK. And these little clips that attach to the track. So you'll see one on that end, one on that end. So this is a 1400 millimeter track. I am probably going to get a 1080 millimeter track, which I think is going to be a little better for this table, so it's not sticking out, because I do want to have it on there most of the time. But really easy to use. You can just flip it up. You can easily slide this up to take it off, put it back down. It holds them absolutely snug against the dogs. Then what you can do, take your track saw, run it along. And another feature with kind of this setup and another accessory that I got from Axminster and UJK is this fence. So this is a 1000 millimeter fence that's running over on this side of the table. So I can reference and push this piece of material. So this is almost 24 inches and it could be a bit longer if I wanted to put this farther. Also, this dog could fit through one of these holes if I wanted to have a really wide piece go all the way up there. So very happy with that fence. It does have this stop. So if I'm making repeatable cuts, just lock that down, cut this piece, throw another piece in, make my cut, and you're gonna be getting great material. So it has a lot of different holes in here. Some of them are oval so that there is a tiny bit of wiggle room, although I'm finding that the grid on this table is absolutely perfect. So any of the PARF accessories that I am using on this, I've had absolutely no issue with. And it is kind of handy to also have that fence kind of closer to the edge of the material rather than having it cut back and having a bit of an overhang. And it would be cool, they make so this 1000 millimeter version, they also make a 600 millimeter version. I wish they made a 30 millimeter version because it would be cool to have it on this side as well, so you could kind of cut between them. One other cool feature with it and with these dogs, and if we take the track off, let's see if I can do this one-handed. Yeah, so the track's off. Just take these dogs out. And this can actually work as a bit of a straight edge as well. So I just imagine that I took this guide off. I could then run my router along here. I could put in some other dogs. Let's see here. I could use other types of dogs at the back in order to kind of push this piece up. If I had another one over there, then it'd be perfectly square. If I wanted to cut dados or something else, I could run my router along here absolutely perfectly. So this is much more versatile than just a fence that you would have at the end. You can also put it on 45 degrees for cutting angles like that. So yeah, so this is kind of where I am right now with this MFT. So I'm going to use it a little bit. And I think that there are a few more things that I'm going to do. I think I am going to round over the edges a little bit when I have my dust extractor cable. It runs across that smoothly, but it's going to damage the sides. Whereas if I rounded it over, it'd probably look a little nicer. I also am still trying to figure out what kind of finish I want to put on top of this. There are a lot of people with a lot of different ideas on what type of finish. I imagine that I'm probably just going to go with two coats of polyurethane. I think that that's what I'm looking at right now. Just put on a very, very thin coat, do a very light sanding, do another very thin coat. I'm not looking to keep it super tidy. I know I'm gonna have to replace this top every so often, and that's totally fine, but it will give a little bit more durability, allowed material to slide over it a little better, and help with some of the moisture issues that we have here in Southern Ontario with humidity. So yeah, I know this was a bit of a longer update. The last update has done pretty well with getting a handful of views and some good feedback from folks. So anyways, let me know what you think. What do you think I should do to kind of make this even more versatile? I am also kind of thinking about putting this little kind of test table that I did, which actually turned out absolutely perfect. I am thinking of mounting that on the side vertically to give me some, almost like a vise in a way when I kind of mix it with some clamps. So to be able to put that kind of on the side, coming up flush on one of the parts here, could be pretty cool. So I am considering that, whether it is with that or whether I make a new one. But I'm thrilled with this so far, so I can't wait to get using it. And there'll probably be another update or two, but definitely not in the next couple days. Probably be a few weeks or even a couple months down the road. So thanks for watching this series so far, and I'll let you know more as I get to it. And there will be a lot more videos on Mason Wood Shop soon. So thanks for watching. See you then.